things began to change in the landscape of Oklahoma with respect to just public licensure in general and professional licensure. As a licensed and ordained minister in Oklahoma, I had concerns about officiating at weddings and funerals, and approached Dan about these concerns, and he invited me to be a part of a panel as they began to investigate whether there was a need for legislative action that might protect the rights of ministers. Through those activities, Dan generated a bill that was introduced in the Senate that ultimately was passed in both the House and the Senate and signed by the governor, called the Minister's Bill of Rights. And what that Minister's Bill of Rights did for me and other ministers in Oklahoma is to protect our ability to officiate in ceremonies that best reflect our views and our values. It became clear to me that Dan is very consistent in how he approaches problems, not just in churches or in ministry or youth work, but with people in general. And through these 18 years, I've been able to trust that Dan is going to not only seriously consider every issue before he makes a decision, but that he's also going to pray about those decisions that he makes, and that the actions that Dan is going to demonstrate, not only at the Senate level, but at the family level and in the community as well, they're all going to be consistent with his values and the foundation upon which he serves. One thing that I might add about Dan is that just getting to work alongside him, I've recognized him as a regular guy, one that isn't just particularly driven about any one particular issue, but one who just appreciates life and family and community and people in general. And the other thing that is really nice for me is just to know that we have someone in leadership in Oklahoma City that I can trust. I have never felt that Dan has given me any answer other than the truth, and I have also trusted that the decisions that he has made on my behalf have been the best decisions.